15 years ago tonight, I'm betting you were sure happy. The tech-heavy NASDAQ had just hit its highest level ever, ever, as in never before, finishing at a staggering 5,048.62 after briefly flirting earlier above the 5,132 level. Little did we know then, the air was already starting to come out, and one of the biggest bubbles in market history was about to pop. By the time of the financial meltdown in 2008, the NASDAQ was little more than a fifth, its former bubblicious self, an enduring lesson that what goes up sometimes comes crashing down. That is where the Federal Reserve comes in, forever trying to keep parties from getting out of hand and meager recoveries from spiraling into something worse. And it is on that tightrope that the Fed now finds itself again, trying to balance an economy and a bubble at the same time. Now, here's what's got everyone in this sort of historic funk, and it's not just this date and this 15-year thing. It is the possibility the Fed is poised to put a damper on another party by raising interest rates from near 0% and possibly piercing two bubbles at the same time, one in bonds, where rates are said to be ridiculously low, and the other in stocks, where enthusiasm is said to be ridiculously high. So you play that one. History suggests it doesn't play out well. Economist Dave Maney says investors have reason to be nervous.
The whole spectacle reminds me of watching Andre the Giant playing Jenga. He's built this impressively tall tower, but now the Fed's got to figure out how to get it apart without having it come tumbling down.
Well,
and
is there a bubble that the Fed has to address then? What do you think?
In effect, I mean, we've had 9 years since they've raised interest rates, and it's created this thing that where everything is priced as if everything's going to go exactly right. There is no major fault. There is no major danger priced into that market, in my opinion. And there's nowhere for it to go, in my opinion, but watch that building sort of come apart.
Okay. What do you think of that what happens here? The Fed overplays its hand and maybe gets us into even deeper doo-doo.
I think that if you imagine one piece of significant bad news hitting somewhere in this market at the same time that they're trying to kind of be this elephant dancing and be very delicate in what is an overinflated situation, I think you could suddenly see things going bad in a hurry, and we might be remembering that night you were talking about 15 years ago, Neil.
Yeah, I was only 10 at the time, but I heard it was a big deal. Guys, thank you both very, very much.